So maybe you don't have the best camera or lens to get that nice bokeh in your image. Well, PIXLR recently released Focus Studio within PIXLR. A quick explanation of what bokeh is. That's the out of focus areas that turn out blurry. That has a lot to do with the aperture you're using on your camera that gives you that narrow depth of field. Oftentimes too, you will see what's called bokeh balls. And that is the round circular effect you get from using a narrow depth of field, as shown here in this sample. So first, head on over to PIXLR.com and we're going to start with PIXLR X. For this example, I'm just going to use some stock photos. So if you click on images, I'm going to search for night, street, and people. And let's start with this image. So on the very left here, you're going to see three new options PIXLR released recently. One of them is glitch, one is focus, and one is dispersion. But today we're just going to look at the Focus Studio. So once you click on focus here on the left, at the very top, you'll see the mode. And this is basically the kind of blur that you want. So if I click on this one, it's going to be symmetrical, where the in focus area will be in this middle area here, and all the blur will be at the top and the bottom. You have radial, which we're going to use today, and you have linear as well. So for this demonstration, I'm going to pick radial. And how this works is you basically just center where you want the focused area to be. So in my case, it'll be the face. And I do want the body in focus too, so I'm going to make this much bigger. And I want most of the body in focus, but I'm going to rearrange it. And you simply just click on the circle here to move the whole thing. And then these areas outside are what's going to be blurry. That's what's going to give you the bokeh. As you can see here, the blur is already really nice and there's nothing wrong with it. But if you want to just give it a bit of extra blur, you see already that it's given some blur there. I'm going to take this off. And you see the differences there. It just enhances that blur even more. Now, if you look on the left, you'll see you have a few options here. You can soften the blur much more. If I crank that up, you see how smooth that is. I'll bring it down to about 57. And then next you have the shapes. I'm going to keep mine at circle, but you can experiment with these other shapes. And you can also make the size bigger and more intense. So if I bring that intensity up, bring the size up, you see how much more blurry that gets, right? So it's almost as if you're using a lens with a really narrow depth of field. Now the next option here, the bokeh shape, this is where you can artificially put those bokeh balls, and you could even, you know, change the shapes here. I'm going to leave it at circle, and you can increase the size, you can, you know, increase the quantity or decrease the quantities and play with the intensities if you really want to bring those out. Now, as I apply that, you see now we have a totally different picture. So if we do a before and after, this is the original. Now it's a bit excessive, but I wanted to show you, you know, the capabilities of using this new feature. So for the second example, I'm going to show you using the symmetric tilt option. And basically, as you see, the previous settings were already set to this one. So you see the bokeh balls and the out of focus areas already applied. But what I'm going to do actually is take off the bokeh shapes. And we're just going to play with the linear blur here. Keep it really simple. Bring the size down a bit and the intensity. And you see here, it's just the middle part that's in focus. We're going to really make that narrow to just around the shoulders and the head area. And just like that, we're going to hit apply, and you see how different of an effect that is compared to what we looked at earlier. Now, of course, as always, you want to get this type of effect in camera first. But if you're using a kit lens or, you know, a more budget-friendly lens and you're limited in terms of how narrow you could put your aperture, this is kind of a way where you can do fake bokeh. And in case you didn't know, PIXLR has a free background remover that you could use for thumbnails or, you know, manipulating your images. Be sure to check it out. I'll leave the link in the card above or in the description below. So yeah, we'll see you then.